Don't say it.
Yeah, I'm not gonna say it. Nope!
Break it, Pepe Le Pew!
As you wish.
The human body has 206 bones, which are hard in structure and provide protection for our internal organs. Without bones, we could not walk, stand, or even sit, which is why movement is limited when there is a bone fracture. A bone fracture is a chipped, cracked, or broken bone. There are more than 600 muscles in the body which work in conjunction with the tendons and ligaments, allowing the body movement and function. Sprains and strains occur when the body is put under physical stress, such as excessive stretching. The body has hundreds of joints that allow the body to move and bend without breaking. Dislocations occur when the bones are forced from their normal position. Fractures, sprains, strains, and dislocations are the most common injuries to bones and joints. It is often difficult to distinguish a sprain from a break. Many of the signs and symptoms are the same for all four injuries. They will all induce pain, swelling, discoloration, and limitation of movement. For this reason, when administering first aid, it is best to treat them all as fractures. Fractures, dislocations, severe sprains, and strains need to be treated cautiously. You should call 911 if the victim can't walk more than four steps without significant pain, can't move the affected joint, has numbness in any part of the injured area, see redness or red streaks spreading out from the injury. The injury involves the spine, neck, or back, a snap or crack that was heard at the time of the incident, an open wound or visible bone, or if there is an obvious deformity. Carry out the acronym AID. Follow the acronym RICE. R. Rest the injured area. Have the victim remain still. Moving the injury may cause more damage to the tissues and aggravate the victim's pain. There may be severe swelling, so remove tight clothing or shoes. I. Immobilize the injury in the position found. Do not move or try to straighten an injured extremity. Placing support materials around the injury, such as rolled clothing or blankets, will help buttress the injured site and reduce damage and pain to the surrounding tissues. C. Cold application and cover. Apply cold compresses, such as an ice pack, over the injured area for 20 minutes on and then 20 minutes off. Do not apply ice directly to the skin. Use a barrier. Cover any open wounds with sterile dressings. A fracture may break through the skin, causing a wound, which will be discussed next. E. Elevating an injured arm or leg will help prevent swelling. Elevate it only if moving the limb does not cause pain. Treat for shock, as with all major illnesses and injuries. Administer emergency oxygen and maintain the body temperature. If the scene is safe and you do not need to move the victim, comfort them until EMS arrives. Do not apply a splint or sling unless the victim needs to be moved or EMS is delayed. Fractures may be open or closed. Bones that break through the skin are called open fractures. Treating an open fracture is the same as a closed fracture, but it also includes control of bleeding. Cover the wound with a sterile dressing and apply pressure. Apply enough pressure to stop the bleeding, but not enough to move the bone. Open fractures are very susceptible to infection and need advanced care by medical professionals. If emergency help is delayed, or if you need to transport the victim, stabilize the extremity with a splint and/or sling in the position found. A sling can help support the weight of the arm and help minimize pain and damage. A sling can be made from a triangular bandage, shirt, scarf, or belt. Your instructor will demonstrate slings later. Many objects can be used for splinting. Magazines, rulers, or rolled blankets will work. Splint above and below the injury site. Use clean dressings to fill gaps in the splint to provide even pressure and help stabilize the extremity. Always check the nail bed to assure the bandage is not too tight. Splints and slings will help reduce pain and prevent further injury to the extremity. Use clean dressings to splint the injury.